Let's look at an example of a microgrid. In this way, you'll get insight about the use of forecasting wind and solar energy for better network control. I will describe a microgrid setup that is located at the Department of Electrical Sustainable Energy. You will get a better idea of how a microgrid could look like, and you'll see how most of the concepts that you've learned merge together. The name of this microgrid setup is DENLAB. DENLAB was built as a demonstration lab for system integration of renewable sources, energy storage, and power electronic devices. In this setup, renewable sources are emulated and control algorithms are implemented and tested. A programmable logic controller, or PLC, is in charge of the automation of the electromechanical processes in the laboratory. A PLC is a digital computer that allows the control of machinery and other devices. In DENLAB, the PLC is used to control the power converter devices. You can see how it looks like in the screen. DENLAB provides flexibility to emulate different load patterns and generation units. This is done by means of 9 power converters and 2 motor generator sets of 5.5 and 30 kilowatts. There are 180 solar panels that can be connected to the test facility or redirected to the grid. The power capacity of the laboratory is 50 kilowatts. The operational behavior and characteristics of the components to be studied in the laboratory can be programmed at the main computer using specialized software. The program can then be downloaded to the PLC. In DENLAB, the control of a microgrid is centralized. In this kind of control, the control commands come from the microgrid, from a microgrid central controller. In DENLAB, this microgrid central controller is a PLC, and the control algorithms are implemented using the main computer. The PLC sends the set points to the 9 power converters that are physically placed at DENLAB. In this way, the power supplied or consumed by the converters can be controlled. Also, the output of the motor generator sets can be controlled. In this way, a variety of components can be emulated, and the real power that will flow in DENLAB can be monitored. The communication between the PLC and the converters is done using a communication protocol called Profibus. The purple cable in the figure allows this communication. Let's see now how the control is applied to DENLAB. In your screen, you will see a diagram of DENLAB. As mentioned before, the PLC sends the control commands to the power converters. According to the control algorithms that were implemented in the main computer and that are executed by the PLC. The currents that flow to the autonomous grid in DENLAB represent the currents that would flow in an analogous physical system. DENLAB can work grid-connected or off-grid. This characteristic is important for a microgrid. In DENLAB, different load profiles are emulated. That means even though we don't have a washing machine or household devices in the lab, the active power that flows through the microgrid is the same as if they were connected. In DENLAB, a load of 10 households is emulated. The load can be assumed uncontrollable, like in traditional power plants, or controllable in the case that we apply demand-side management techniques, such as demand response. In this setup, the emulation of the wind turbine is done with the help of a power converter and a motor generator set. Wind speed data is obtained from an anemometer placed on the roof of the building. This is the input of the wind turbine model. The wind turbine model calculates the power that would be supplied by a wind turbine for the respective wind speeds. The converter's set point is calculated from the power output of the model. The converter sets are connected to the motor generator sets. As a consequence, a change in the set point of the power converter makes the motor generator set to turn slower or faster. In a real system, that motor generator set would be substituted by wind turbine. By using wind and solar forecasting, the control algorithm defines when to charge or discharge. Autonomous systems and islanded systems face stability challenges, particularly when most of the generation comes from their renewable sources. For these reasons, storage devices or backup systems are required. The use of forecasting methods can allow the system to make the best use of the storage devices, depending on the weather conditions. If, for example, today is a cloudy day, but it is forecasted that tomorrow will be a sunny day, the optimization algorithm may decide that it is a good idea to make use of the storage unit now, because there will be the possibility to charge it tomorrow. Today, you were able to get acquainted with a real setup of a microgrid system. I hope that you enjoyed it. The integration of renewable energy poses challenges at different levels in the power system. In this course, you have been briefly introduced to the different relevant concepts. You have learned about the structure of a traditional power system, and you have learned about the main changes that are likely to occur. You have also learned about the need for power converters and the need for control and forecasting. I hope that this course has opened your interest to dive into this topic even further. I hope to see you again in the future.